Let's go.
Again?
Oh, it doesn't matter.
Okay, so this is what we finished so far. We finished morning basket, devotional, our worship and workout with our morning walk, token time, snack, morning binder. We finished our language arts today, and we are on science. But we are kind of joining it with morning read aloud and lunch, which is actually afternoon read aloud and lunch. So we're gonna get started on science, do some lunch, finish science, read aloud, and then we have these three left before school is over.
Where is the... Oh, it's over here, right?
Where?
No, I mean, I'm looking for a... Oh, yeah, that's over here. Oh, that's a lot of words. Oh! Finland. And here's Sweden.
See, this is the struggle. So they had on completely different outfits this morning because it is cold. But now they've changed it into short sleeve shirts. Because they speak both Swedish and Finnish in Finland. Okay, you ready?
It's actually
good. Hi guys, today I am going to do another Q&A, and this time it is about my schedule. So I have my phone again and I wrote down a lot of the questions that I get about our schedule and kind of sort of planning. I am currently getting lunch for the kids and I'm hiding out in Savannah's room because it is a really rainy day, and I just thought this would be a good time to just go ahead and get some of these questions answered. So I think I have like 2.5 minutes before they find me. So the first question is, how has your schedule changed? Is it still the same? So my schedule is in a really, really good place. But the way that our schedule works is that it takes into account the flexibility that we need in homeschool, if that makes any sense. So basically, we're still doing the block schedule. We school 4 days a week, so we do Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Our math and language arts are on a block. So we do math on Tuesday, Thursday, language arts on Monday, Wednesday. And basically how it goes, I don't know if you've seen some of the vlogs with our actual schedule in it. We take care of morning work, morning basket, first thing when we start. We go off on our morning walk. After we get back, we take care of token time, Bible, and any of like our morning meeting type things. After that, we move into whatever block it is. If it's a Monday or Wednesday, we are doing language arts. If it's a Tuesday or Thursday, we are doing math. Which, by the way, so for language arts and math, how we actually handle it is there is a portion that is kind of one-on-one time with mommy, and then there's another portion that's kind of like their independent work on their devices. So normally we flip-flop. I school my boys together and then Savannah is separate. So I'll do the boys, and then while I am doing one-on-one time with the boys, Savannah is doing her device work. And then we switch. So then I'm doing one-on-one work with Savannah and the boys are doing their device work. So after we finish language arts or math, then we move on to either read aloud time and then into our unit work. So our unit work is basically like our theme. So for right now, we are moving into the water and our world and the weather unit. So that is what we are doing there. So whatever I have planned for the day for us to get into that is related, directly related to our unit study, is when we do that. After we finish that up, normally we have a little bit of a break time and then we come back and handle our electives, and our quiet reading time is normally somewhere in there. So how I lay out our electives has been the same for quite some time. I know a lot of people do a looping basket as not to miss a specific subject so much. And I don't know, it just didn't work too well for us. I just needed a constant reminder that it doesn't have to be a big deal, Serena. So for me to have specific days that are for specific subjects means that I have to be learning something in relation to that subject, even if it's not what I have planned. And to me, I just feel like it was more of a consistent exposure to specific ideas that are categorized based on subject than trying to wait for this opportunity to kind of get it all in. I know that probably did not make any sense, but that was the best way that I could explain it. So what we do is on Mondays, we cover writing. On Tuesdays is our geography day. On Wednesdays is our science day. And I've had this question before that I've answered before, but I'll go ahead and reiterate that our unit work and our science time on Wednesdays are different time periods because oftentimes our unit work is science related, but it's not always science related. So sometimes our units could be on robots or computers or things like that. But I always wanted to have some extra time to just kind of uncover some natural science, like cooking science, or if we found a different type of rock and we want to discover what the rock is. I just found that not having that time in there for us to kind of zone in on just those basic everyday science type of things was just kind of not serving us well. So having our unit work, but then in addition to that, having some time on Wednesday where we cover some basic science lessons just works out better for us. So on Wednesdays we do science, and on Thursdays we do history. That is the last part of our day, and then normally we end it off with a little bit of quiet reading time and then getting out of here. So that's how we do that. Did that make any sense? So that's in general how our schedule goes. It changes based on what I need for whatever season we're in and what we have going on. But the way that I have built the schedule, it's easy to just kind of move around and adjust if I need to, but we still stick to that similar plan. And it's been working so well. Like, so well, you guys. So there are certain parts of the day that are considered more independent work, and they're able to do those things outside of our school time. If they do that, then they're considered an early finisher. So, but we still move along with that same rhythm of the day. It's just that when we get to math or language arts time, if they've already completed their work on their own time, they're considered an early finisher, so they can choose something else to do other than what I had assigned. They can choose something else to do, but it still has to do with that specific subject. So for instance, in history, if we're covering Noah's Ark in our history time, but they completed everything that I had scheduled for that day, then they can choose to do something like read one of the Who Was books, or play or work on our Noah's Ark project. It has to be history related, but they've already completed what was assigned. So that works out really well, and it gives them this sense of ownership over their day? How much time do you spend planning each week? So that's a tricky question as well, because I feel like I plan all day long in my head. I'm constantly thinking of things that we can do and things that we can try and all of that other stuff. But as far as sitting down, opening up books and things, I plan maybe once a month or once every 2 months. And I plan very heavily on that first week that we move over into like a new unit or a new area of study. Then I'm able to space those plans out amongst the weeks to follow. Then every Saturday, Sunday, I just go and revisit my plans that I had already laid out at the beginning, and I just kind of adjust anything that I need to adjust based on what we have going on in life. So I hope that helps. The next one, how do you schedule your subjects in unit studies? I'm not sure I understand this completely, but I think what you may be saying is, where do my unit studies fit in? So I used to have my unit study just kind of cover everything in our school, and that didn't work out well. Now I allocate a specific time of our day to unit study work. And that comes after we finish our core work, which is language arts, math, reading, that type of thing. After that and before electives is where our unit study falls. The next one is, how do you get your kids to read so much? Oh my gosh, I schedule time and I make it a thing. So we have two separate special times for reading, which is quiet reading time and our read aloud time. Read aloud is when mommy in general is reading, and then sometimes the kids will read to everyone as well. But I'm normally reading or daddy's reading. Quiet reading time is when we all kind of separate and read together, but separately. So I'll read a little something in a book I'm working on, and they will read their individual books. And then I have another like bedtime reading where Brian will read to them. So I have two or three special times that we spend reading. Then in addition to that, anytime that they're reading above those allocated times, they get tokens for. So they do get rewarded for choosing to read outside of those times that I allow during the day. We have a lot of fun with it. I don't know if it's just because my kids are like all for whatever whatever idea I have or whatever, but it works out really well. I praise them really big. We really get into it. We use voices and everything, which I'm sure you guys are doing as well. But I try not to force things. I try to find stories that I feel like would be exciting for us. And my book notes have been a really big deal around here. And the book year in general has been a big deal around here. Also, the book gallery, which I will mention in my book year video, has been a big thing as well. So the next one is, how do you make time to teach? And I think that when I began that whole serious reading journey, I decided that kids like to do what they see you do. So if you're reading all the time, if you're on the computer all the time, they want to be on the computer all the time. So I noticed that and I was like, well, I need to open up a book and I need to read more. So I started doing that intentionally, like open up a book so when they come around the corner and they see mommy, they see me reading something. And I think that kind of started it or set the tone for the things that were to come. And I think it's been working well. So I hope that helps. And the last one is, how do you make time to teach all three of your kids? This is an interesting question, and I totally understand it. I think I'm gonna do a separate video on that one so that I can show you. I can probably show you a lot better than I can tell you, but it's a lot of juggling, and I had to really pay attention to my kids' rhythms and how we work well together to get to a space where I feel like I have a better handle on that now. And it changes for any given time because your kids are always growing, right? And their temperaments change and the things that they're capable of sitting through changes. So gosh, that's a hard one, and I'm gonna do a separate video on it. Anyway, I think my time is up. I need to go check on them because I'm sure that they've ruined something. But But thank you guys so much for watching and for listening to me answer these questions. I am enjoying doing these Q&As, so leave all your questions in the description box below. If you have any comments and things, make sure you give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and I will see you in our next video.